Hello everyone and welcome back to Zoo Crafting! I am Zookeeper Siri. Even if I'm currently not in my zookeeper outfit, don't panic. I'm just wearing my woodland forest outfit so that I am ready to do some hard work of cutting down some trees and preparing some lumber and building all sorts of amazing new areas for our temperate forest zone of the zoo, which is where we are currently at and where we are currently working. And you guys may see a couple big giant birdo feet back there because Asterseed is back! Asterseed, how are you doing, buddy? He has been up in the nest of Sunflower's tree with his beautiful mate Sunflower and their many, many cheekabos for quite some time now. But thankfully, they are getting big enough that Sunflower is able to watch them for just a moment so that Asterseed can come over and help me build and expand the zoo. So thank you for that, buddy. If I can find you some Geischel greens, I will totally bring some to you because I know how much you love them. But Asterseed's here because we are going to be working on a build, finally. After so long, we are going to be working on a build today. Oh, hi, Asterseed. Oh, I love you too. I love you too, buddy. And we are going to be building the picnic pickup food stall. And that is going to be a lot of fun because that's where we are going to be making these little rucksacks, these little backpacks, and we're going to be turning them into picnic baskets. Normally on Fridays, you guys know, we end up cooking a bunch of the delicious foods that Pam's Harvest Craft and the Plant Mega Pack plant, or the Plant Mega Pack mod. Oh my goodness, that's a mouthful. And all of the other mods, including the custom foods we are going to be learning to make and the modded food that we will be adding into our world in the future, hopefully to be able to share with you guys at some point too. But there's so many different foods in the world and I love cooking with them. Thus, Zoo Kitchen, which actually a ton of people really love, and you guys come up with amazing food names for specialties that we can sell here in the zoo every week. But one of the different restaurants that we're going to be opening for this zoo is the Picnic Shop, so that people can come over and there'll be like a little food stall right here, and they can go ahead and grab these little backpacks, and these little backpacks will be picnic baskets, and we'll put in some like red and white wool so it looks like a little picnic blanket, and then we'll put in the food in the center, and people can leave their payment in a little chest, and it's meant for the other members of the server, either the other zoo crafters or the residents or guests who we happen to have on. And so then people can come over and they can jump on in and they can be like, oh, this meal looks delicious, I'll take this picnic basket, and they will take the food, leave the payment, empty the food out of the backpack, and be able to sit down on our lovely little picnic blankets we are going to be making. And then they can put the little backpack back into like the empty food chest. That's the goal. And then every week when we do Zoo Kitchen, we can come over and we can go, oh, I hope people have come by and they have shopped at our picnic place, Alia. And we can pick up the empty backpacks, aka the picnic baskets, and we can take them back home and we can make up fresh food that we will then cook during Zoo Kitchen and resupply the food shops. So that's kind of the goal. So that way it's not just like having the NPCs, because we do have a few NPCs who will sell an infinite supply of certain foods to all of our guests. But I like that sense of interaction with being able to change the menu. Then it's more exciting for me because I get to actually like manually prepare the food, and I actually really enjoy that. I think it's a fun part of our world and what we do here in Minecraft. And then I also think it's really fun because the other zoo crafters or the guests that they might invite on or the residents that we might have who aren't zoo crafters but also live in our world and work in our world, even if they are hidden people and you may not know who they are, but those people may come over and they never know what they're going to find. They never know what kind of picnic meal they may get. It may be summer themed things when we have the Aukies harvesting up so many summer foods inside of the garden. And when it turns winter, maybe we'll end up with like some warmer meals. Maybe we'll have hot cocoa tucked in there. Sometimes it might be like fresh harvested cherries that I'll just pluck from the trees right behind the shop and stick in there. Sometimes we might garnish it with like some of these herbs that we can just come over and we can be like, oh, wow, that's a lot of coffee. I might just brew up some coffee for like everybody and stick it straight in. Like we could make some espresso, or we could like make some coffee powder. We could make like just, oh, there's so many things. We can just like whip up some coffee and tuck it in just because that's what we wild harvested from behind the picnic stand. And I think that would be so much fun. So I really like that idea of kind of having a rotating variety of foods, and we manually stock the shop, and the picnic shop just is one of the many, many sources, many, many places that we'll do that in, but it's the one I'm most excited about right now. The other place we kind of do that in right now, and I need to advertise it. Advertising, thank you so much, Asterseed. Advertising's probably gonna, oh, there's a butterfly right there. Where's my butterfly net? Where's my butterfly net? Okay, come here. Come here, my friend. Did I get you? Get in my net. Why won't, oh, I caught it! Yay! I caught a wood white female. Okay, it's not the green butterfly I wanted, but now I have all of my butterfly nets full, so that makes me happy. All right, so let me go ahead and tuck these butterflies in my butterfly net away because now I'm out of empty butterfly jars. I need to go buy some more and expand my butterfly collection, which is getting quite large now. But yeah, I need to advertise some of these things to the other zoo crafters. Otherwise, they'll never know to be able to come and like eat all of the food. And we could do tours and we could just have like a nice day here at the zoo and learn some new things. But the syrup shack right over here is actually another place that we're going to set up just like that so that people can come over and they can get some fresh like cooked pancakes, they can get some fresh waffles, you guys can help me name all of these things, they can have maple sausage, which here is made with tofu at our zoo, but they don't need to know that. It tastes like real sausage as far as they're concerned. They could come and get all of these foods, and sometimes we might add in like maybe some fried eggs or some fruit salads, different kinds of sides to go with it, and people can just come over here, they can kind of get the food fresh served up hot, and we'll have a little NPC selling them, and hopefully dogs won't have danced on their waffles. That may or may not be included. Ha-ha, maybe that's a perk for some people. And then they can leave their payment, like whatever their payment may be, either the coins or maybe they'll have something they think is appropriate barter. And every week when we go around to our shops or whenever we happen to go by the shops, we can collect whatever it is and take it back with us. So I really, 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 really love this idea. So there's the basic premise of it, because I know a few guys probably aren't familiar with what we're planning on doing. And then here is where we are going to be building it. And now let's get down to the business of building. All right, Lily, you go ahead and sit down by the intertwined oak trees. Alia, sit. There we go, good girl. All right, Nyriss, I'm gonna scoot you over because I think I need to work over there. And now, my friends, let's put on our armor and cross our fingers that we won't be attacked by random hostile mobs while we are attempting to get this built and get this done. All right, so let me put some of the birch saplings away and put on my armor just to make sure we're good to go. Wonderful, look at the moon rise over the trees. So beautiful. And then we're going to go ahead and just dive right in. Hang in there, Aster Seed. He's actually here in case we need to fly back to the house for supplies. So that's why Aster Seed's here. But we're going to just go ahead and dive in. And we're going to try to see if we can finish up the picnic shack today. And maybe like level this area out a little bit. Get it looking nice. I think we should probably remove some of the surrounding dirt first off. But yeah, we'll try to make this area look pretty nice. Get the little picnic stand up so that we can start making the picnic baskets. And we can really start getting... Oh, goodness. Well, I'm just digging straight into that dirt really quickly there, aren't I? All right. Well, we'll have to replace some of that. But yeah, I want to start being able to fill the picnic baskets up and like advertise. And I know one of the things we want to do, I mean, you guys saw the clubhouse a few days ago. Wasn't that amazing? Is more community interaction where we kind of all work together, like doing things like either club related things or just visiting each other's areas more often. And there's more people that we're looking into bringing in. So it's just a really wonderful experience all around. And I want to have the picnic shop done. That's just my goal. I don't have to explain it anymore. It's just my goal, you guys. I'm really excited about it. All right, so I'm going to put these away and I can put the rubber wood away. And I kind of have an idea of what we are going to be doing over here. So we'll just whip up a crafting station really quickly so we can get to work. There we go. And I think a crafting station probably right back here is fine. Hopefully nobody will try to jump into the Red Wolf exhibit from over here. There we are. All right, so let's clear these dandelions out of the way and let's actually clean up these herb gardens. So if we were wild harvesting right now, what would the herb garden cook? A bit of coffee, quite a bit of celery, some ginger, quite a bit of tea actually. So it looks like it would mostly be coffee and tea, which is quite interesting to me. And there's some mustard too. So maybe we would make some mustard to put on like a sandwich, or maybe we would like add mustard. How can you do that with mustard? Like maybe we would just go ahead and put the mustard in something, but maybe we could just put like mustard and ketchup in the picnic basket with like fries and things like that. That would be kind of cute. So then even if you, I guess you could try eating the mustard raw, but even if you don't eat the mustard or the ketchup raw, you could take it home and then maybe you could make your own food with it. So that could be kind of fun. All right. And don't mind the poo. That's just the Red Wolf poo because I've been running back and forth past their exhibit. So I've been cleaning up the poo as I go, as a good zookeeper would. Is that one of the Red Wolves? Yeah, look, there's Redwood. Redwood the Red Wolf. Talk about a tongue twister. All right, so we'll clear these out of the way. And I know all around here we're going to be putting in the picnic blankets. And somewhere nearby, we are going to be building the black bear exhibit, because I'm really looking forward to that. Probably kind of where that little cave system is. Man, it's been so long since we've been caving. I kind of have a bit of a hankering for some caving. We might do that sometime soon. All right, let's tuck all of this out of the way so I can see what I'm doing while I'm cooking, or not cooking, while I'm building. And I need my chisel really quickly. So let's see how quickly we can throw this up. So we're gonna go ahead and do these really cool planks on the bottom. And then the sides are actually going to be these large oak wood planks, because I really like those. And the tops, we are actually going to recolor this right here, the oak wood parquet. Except I don't want oak wood, I want birch wood, because it's lighter. So it'll make for a better carpenter block dyed block with the birch wood. All right. Don't worry, after years of doing this, I kind of have a bit of a flow to how we build. Especially because we do have a few buildings built. I'll just look at them really quickly. Like, here is our temperate forest bird aviary. And you guys saw the syrup shack. And then down here, this is just like a little observational post. So people can come up and they can kind of get a good view of like what there is to see on this side. And then over there, you can actually see where we have the future education center that I've kind of built. I like the little, I really am very proud of the little Lily of the Valley that are on the archway there. But you can kind of get an idea. Oh, and there's more beautiful butterflies. Oh, the little goldfinches are so beautiful. I love their song. I do too, Keeper Adelaide. I also love all these butterflies, and I'm sad I'm out of butterfly nets, especially because there's green ones that show up here from time to time. I would love a green butterfly. That is worth leaving, like, in barter trade. I'm almost more excited to see what people barter trade me for, like, picnic baskets. And, I mean, they have to leave the basket, mind you, so I don't expect a lot. But I would almost like to see what people would try to barter trade me than anything else, than rather than leave like the wooden coins or other forms of money. And some of the villages that the other people are building will actually use different forms of money than the wooden coins we use. So that's going to be really fun to see come together. All right, now I don't think that the picnic, little picnic shop needs to be too big. I just want it to be a small little food stand. You can walk up, you can like pick out your picnic meal and you can walk away. But it does need to have enough room for a couple chests. So let's make a couple chests really quickly, because we need at least one chest where people can go. We need at least one chest where people will be able to go and like pick up the picnic bag. Little picnic baskets. So this is just kind of temporary. And then we need one chest where people can drop them off. Oh, and then we're going to need another chest. Or maybe we should put, let's put the picnic baskets like in shelves actually. So I'll make some shelves in a minute because we don't have any walls to put them on just yet. But we will need to put the picnic baskets probably on shelves so they're like on display so people can just like reach up and pick one out. So maybe I should actually, how am I going to make this? Maybe we should have a little wall right here and then you can come up. Yeah, like a little open wall where you can just kind of like pick out your picnic basket and you can kind of see the person on the other side. Maybe. Or maybe it'll just be like a display where you can walk up and you can just like pick one off of the display. I like that idea too. All right, let's just put up the walls and we'll start there. All right, so don't mind me. A little bit of muttering. It's been so long since we've built something. It's kind of surreal, isn't it? All right. And then that's definitely the spot I want it in. Maybe. Do I want to scooch it over a little bit? I probably want to put it right there so that it'll blend in with the ground. Oh, hey, look at this. Cool. We got an Amalite shard. I really love collecting those randomly from the dirt. It's kind of neat. All right. Then how big do I want to make this? That was the question, wasn't it? So I definitely know. All right. That these walls are good. I don't know how I'm gonna want to do the corners. Probably as oak wood pieces, to be honest. Oh, did I use all my oak wood? All right, there's some new oak wood. That should do. So we'll probably do like oak wood at the corner pieces all the way down. Like so. And then that would go across. So maybe I need to do it one more out. I know, right, Esther Seed? It's been so long since we built something. It's so surreal. All right. Actually, I'm probably going to need that. Hey, get out of there, Shears. All right. So then this is where we're going to have, let's see. people will need to be able to pay, so they need to have like a little chest where they can like leave their barter trade or the money that I can pick up every week. And then they need to have a little chest where they can drop off their used picnic baskets. So probably like one that would just be right here would actually be really good. And let's see, what do I want to put on the floor? Probably just normal oakwood planks, I think. So this is probably good enough. All right. Oh, and the dawn is coming up. Isn't that light beautiful? Phew, that's gorgeous. All right. So they need to have a spot to leave the picnic basket, or the picnic, like, well, they are baskets, even if they're going to be made out of leather. So they need to have a spot to leave them. And then they need to have a spot. There we go. And then they need to have a spot to pick them out from. And I guess it would be a lot more fun if we, like, died, because you can actually take these, you can take these backpacks and you can combine them with dye and make them into all sorts of different colors. For example, let's see, backpack. See, you can have like all these different color backpacks. So we can make a whole bunch of different colors and just put like random foods in there. It'll be really fun. And it would be more fun if people could kind of walk up and like pick from a rack, wouldn't it? Like if they could reach up and pick one. And if I try to put it behind the NPC, it would be difficult to reach. Like behind a counter, it would be pretty difficult to reach. But maybe if I make it small enough, let's do this. Sorry guys, it's been so long since I've built, but you guys are used to my pace. All right, and then if I had, what did I use? What on earth did I use, Aster Seed, for the counter? I guess that's good for the counter. And then you can just walk up. And no, you wouldn't be able to reach the shelves if they were at the back, would you? What if we had, like, well, okay, hang on a second. We're gonna experiment for a minute. Enough trying to pretend this is Minecraft. You always start building something and end up taking it apart a little bit as you figure out how you're gonna make it better. All right, so we'll do this. And then I need to come over and we'll remove this. And then my poor little NPC will probably need a door, and I'm gonna need a door to be able to get in and out. So let's see, we don't need to really worry about the bottom one there. And then we'll do this, and we'll do this. And then across here will probably be like a little beam, maybe. I'll have to see how I did the other buildings to kind of make it match. So probably a thin beam is what I'll use right there instead of that big guy. And then you come up and you need to be able to pick out your picnic baskets. And you also need to be able to leave your old picnic basket. So if this was the chest where you drop off your used picnic baskets, then being able to come over here, I kind of like that idea again that I had of having like some shelves right there. So let's figure out how that would look. All right, so I'm trying to remember how to make shelves. Let's see, shelves. There we go. So a little oak shelf. I need some slabs and an oak wood plank. Whoops, and I need to work that right there. There we go. All right, there's a few slabs. And then we put the oak wood plank there, and then boom, like that. And then we'll grab a few of these. All right, and we'll leave the oak wood there for a second. Oh, more butterflies. So then, yeah, then you could come over here. And what if you came over here and you can just pick from the picnic baskets right here? That should actually work out a lot better than I thought it would. I thought it would look a little bit weird, but it's actually kind of charming. So, all right, we'll do that again. So maybe a few more shelves, just you never know how many you might need. All right, we'll do that. And then a few more shelves. Put that there. Look at it come together. We'll definitely redo the oak beams across the top. Whoops-a-daisy. And then you kind of want to put your shelves together. This actually reminds me when I got, because Chips and I just moved into a new home, yeah? And I picked out some beautiful butterflies, and I have no jars. I could still catch them, but it would kill them, and I would feel kind of bad, so I'm not going to. But Chips and I just moved into our new house in Michigan, and I ordered a really adorable little nightstand to put my geckos up on. And nightstand came, and I was like, oh, this shouldn't be too bad. I've put together like IKEA furniture and stuff like that before. So I thought it would be easy peasy, Aster Seed, Lily, Iris, and Alia, to put it together. And it was from like a major retailer that begins with M and ends with Mart. It begins with W and ends with Mart, if that helps. But it turns out, no, it actually had the holes in the wrong places. I had to screw entirely new things in. Long story short, I couldn't even get the drawer to work. So that's what like putting these shelves in kind of reminds me of, how quickly that disintegrated into complete chaos. So hopefully we'll be able to do better here. All right, I like how I did this, where I set the the back in by one instead. That's actually pretty attractive. So maybe we'll go and we'll do that. And then I want to do a roof. Ouch! What the heck? Chestnut! Rude! Rude! I'm going to eat you. I'm going to retaliate and eat you because you jammed me right in the head. And I kind of want to make a roof like that roof now that I think about it. Look at all these butterflies just flying by me. You butterfly away. That's what Chip says whenever he sees a butterfly. He says, you butterfly away. Oh, look at it, you guys. Gosh, they're so pretty. And it's gone. So now I just took a picture of like empty ivy. That's fine. Oh, goodness gracious. But yeah, I kind of want to do a bit of a roof with some of those pieces. But we used those pieces on the bottom, didn't we? Huh. We'll figure it out. Let's keep going. The only way you can get something done is by showing up and doing the work. And that's what we have figured out so far with our adventures and misadventures in zoo crafting over the years. Oh, and I need some carpenter's blocks. That's what I was working on over here. But let's try removing these. And then what I think we'll do is we will make like a little roof right there out of those blocks. I want to see what that looks like. I kind of like it because it's sort of set in a little bit, but then we'll give it a proper roof as well. And then we need to dig out the woof poop, believe it or not. I need to find where I have put the woof poo, and I need to grab a oak sapling. So here's an oak sapling, and now I need to find the woof poop. Ah, there's the woof poop. Wonderful. What am I doing, you may ask? Don't worry. Siri hasn't just gone, like, zookeeper poo crazy. We are actually going to cut down this little teensy tiny tree. When you use the woof poo, which is enriched soil from the garden stuff mod, you get this lovely teensy itty bitty little oakwood post. And they actually are very attractive if you are going to be using them as, like, decorative pieces. I like it. I like it. I don't know if I need to actually go around... I don't know if I need to actually go around and like put it out like this. I think that actually it's kind of cute, isn't it? Because it sort of reminds me of a picnic basket. So you know what? I'm gonna do it. All right, more wolf poop, more oak tree saplings. We've got this. That's right, Aster Seed. If you're lucky, I won't even need to fly you back to the house. At this rate, everything is just kind of coming together from just the land around us. Isn't that really cool, you guys? I really like that. All right, I know, right, Aster Seed? Alright, so we're going to do that. I really kind of like that, actually. And we'll go ahead and we'll stick another one out there. I don't think we need to do it like that. Well, maybe we can. Man, those little oakwood posts are kind of adorable. Alright. Yes, adorable. I used that word. Alright, and I know it still looks weird, but that's because we need to kind of offset it with a little bit of color here and there, if you ask me. So, Alright, so next thing... Oh, speaking of color... So many beautiful butterflies flying over our head, and I can't do anything about it. I need to have more butterfly jars. I need to have my butterfly house made. That would make me a very happy camper, but we'll worry about that later. For now, let's go ahead and we are going to make some carpenter's blocks, because that's the next step for what we need to do. All right. Hey, go down. There we go. All right, got some of those. That should be plenty of carpenter's blocks like that. And actually, I think you do this, yeah, to make it into these carpenter stairs. So actually, I need more carpenter's blocks. Never mind. I take it back. There we go. All right, wonderful. And then we're going to go ahead. Yay! All right, we got this. Oh, I'm so excited because I could just chase those picnics right now. You guys may be thinking, oh, Siri, you're just doing a little building today, eh? And it's like, no, you guys, I'm preparing my picnic empire. You may think this is just some sort of innocent Siri is just having a great time building episode, but no. No, today is a day where you are seeing the foundation of my picnic empire. I'm quite pleased. All right, we're going to put those away. All right, good, good, good. And we're going to jump up here. And the other thing I need is light blue dye, because I really want to use light blue dye on this creation. And it will make sense when you see where I'm going with this. All right, hang in there. And we'll put these guys down and put these guys down. And I would love to see if you guys built like a little picnic shack that was better than this. Totally let me see it, and maybe I'll redesign the whole thing. What? I already ran out of carpenter's blocks. That wasn't supposed to be part of the deal. I was supposed to have enough to get that done. Oh, well. I always run out of carpenter's blocks. I always go, oh, this should be enough. And it's never enough. All right, that's fine. We've got this. There, that should be plenty, hopefully. Ha. Watch, I'm going to be eating those words in a few minutes. And then we'll jump up here. At the very least today, we can get the little picnic thing set up, even if we're going to need to spend the next few days kind of doing the things. Like, I want to visit people and give them gifts, too. I've just wanted to get this done first so I can let everybody know, hey, my cute little picnic stand is opened up. Come and eat all the picnics that your tummy desires. That's kind of what I've been holding off on visiting everybody for. All right. And then we come over here. No, why are you the wrong way? Don't go that way, go that way. There we go. All right, then we go here, go here, go here. No, you're also the wrong way. There we go. I don't know what you think you're doing, but it's not going the right direction. There we go. Look at all these butterflies flying over our head while we build. This is such a good scenic area. I could see people really enjoying coming here, not only for the sake of the animals and the education, maybe to work a little bit as zookeepers if they happen to be needing a little bit of money or a little bit of delicious food to see them through their day. All right, sorry, vines. I really wanted to collect you, but I kind of have to just scoot you out of the way for a minute. All right, there we go. But I could just see people wanting to come here because it's so green. Butterfly. I will catch you. I would happily give a picnic to anybody who had a green butterfly. I would give 2 picnics. I would give 3 picnics. I would give many, many, many picnics. All right, and we're gonna go ahead and line these guys up right here. You need to go in a new spot too, so I'll put you where you belong in a minute. All right, good thing I have enough birch wood. All right, hang in there, you guys. So carpenter's block birch wood on the top to make the little roof, like so. And then we're going to come down. I need to grab a couple pieces. And let's see, one piece. Is that good? Yeah, one piece right there. Step back. It's looking cuter. I feel like maybe the roof could be a little bit lower. Or maybe we could put, like, something across here. I feel like something needs to go across here. Maybe a decoration? We'll get there. We'll figure it out. But now I need to get some blue dye. Thankfully, we have many wild blue flowers scattered all around us. And these blue flowers turn into light blue dye. So we need to go around and collect up some of those flowers. And that's where my beloved pup-pups come in quite useful. So don't worry, Aster Seed. I won't make you join in this kibbidly-bob just yet. I'm so hungry. Suddenly, I'm struck with hunger. Siri can't move. Fatigue sets in. Giraffe Link sub sandwich to the rescue! Yay! And there's lots of pretty flowers right there, but I don't want to pick those ones. So we're going to actually come and pick the ones that are kind of like meandering around the path over here. And while we're back here, probably won't hurt just to throw down a few of the little torches. Because one day we will have to light this place up. Today is partially that day. Just partially. All right, we need to go around and collect enough of these. In the rain, no less, enough of these hydrangea flowers that we'll be able to completely work on. All right, we'll have to come over here and grab these ones. They'll be able to do the entire roof to the picnic, to the little picnic pickup spot. The picnic pickup food stall. Picnic pickup, that's just what we're going to call it. It doesn't even need a descriptor after that. It's just the picnic pickup. All right, there's that. See, that's 16. Crawling under oak trees. This is what I love about our world, you guys. We get to just bring it to life in the most random, hilarious ways. Who foresaw climbing through a forest, trekking through the mud, crunching leaves under our feet, rustling? Doesn't this grass look like there should just be a Pokemon popping right out of it? That's what I feel about this grass. Who knows, maybe we'll have like a badger or like a raccoon pop out of this grass, or with my luck, a werewolf, which really would be a little bit of bad news bears, but we would roll with it. All right. Oh jeez, there is a raccoon popping out of the grass. Oh, that's hilarious. All right, so there's that. I think this should be enough, but we'll grab a couple more. We'll take, oh wow, there's a lot over here. Jeez, deer, a wild deer to startle the bedoodles out of me. All right, and we'll walk down here. I know, hang on, girls. Hang on, I know, we're really trekking through the leaves now. Oh gosh, just about walked into a little pond. All right, and we'll just kind of throw up some torches as we walk. I mean, you would think I haven't lived near this area for a year for how unsettled it is, but we'll get there eventually. Oh, it looks like my guess would be we have actually had, look, there's a little snail in the rain. Somehow that's one of the most like beautiful things I've seen in a long time. And it looks like we have a local int who's putting down some trees and putting down some mushrooms. Oh, geishel greens! I did say to Aster Seed I would bring him back some geishel greens if I stumbled on some. I think getting rid of the oak saplings is okay. There we go. So I'll bring Astroseed back some Geischel greens and see if he's in the mood for them. All right, but that should be plenty of the blue flowers. So, now we're behind the snake exhibit, just like that. Wonderful. So let's see if we can finish up our picnic pickup spot. Not the entire thing, but at least we made good headway. And it is related to a Zoo Kitchen episode, like, because it's Friday and I normally like focusing on Zoo Kitchens on Fridays. There we go. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. Perfect coloring. Perfect coloring. But it is very, very related. Ah, there we go. To a Zoo Kitchen episode because we're actually getting an area where we're going to be selling the food prepared. I am so excited. All right. And then we'll put that there and that there and that there. Oh, what? I need more? I need, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I need 7 more blue flowers. Oh gosh, and I want to get the ones from the wilderness versus the ones that are like right in front of the exhibit because those are decorative. Okay, all right, well, we're almost there. And then once we finish that, we'll probably be done for the day because it's been a very, very long day now. But I'm really happy because it's not often we get to start from clearing a build to finishing a build, even if it was just a tiny little food stall. Oh goodness, and the horses are scaring the bedoodles out of me. There's some fairy slippers. Look at how beautiful our wild world is. I can't get over that. Oh gosh. Oh, and the tulips. Little wild patch of tulips that we get to stumble on. Oh, I love that. Climbing up and fighting with the birch tree. Ah, no! I needed that birch tree. Fighting with the birch tree so that I can grab the last of the blue flowers that I need. Wandering past wild horses and sheep. And gathering up like these blue flowers while the girls are trekking behind me. Scents of the wild wolves that they are at their noses. Ah, I love this world. I really, really love this world. And I can't wait to be done. Oh, there's my flower. There we go. And I can't wait to be done with this because I haven't visited any of the new people from Edson all the way over to all the other new ones because I wanted to get this done first. Ah, it's a long story, but once I get something like ordered in my head, I have an immensely hard time changing like the schedule of things when I've decided I want to do things in a certain order. So it's a silly thing, but it's a Siri thing. All right, so there, now we have enough flowers. Sorry, Astroseed. He's probably like, I left the comfort of my warm nest with my mate for this. Oh dear. All right, there we go. Whew. All right, finally done that. And we can come over. And I just need to do like a couple more pieces at the back. This can probably be that, and then dun, dun, dun. And now we have a little patch of hidden grass right there. Don't mind that at all. Whoops. Kind of needed to put the birch wood down. There we go. All right. There we go, you guys. So I'm thinking what we could do. So this is supposed to be the picnic pickup spot. I'm thinking what we could do right here is maybe a sign to go right here and kind of come down just a little bit. Maybe it could be, I thought that was a zombie and it startled me. Maybe it could be like a picnic blanket sign. And then what we could do is have like a, just like picnic pickup in DaVincing right there. And it would add color and then we would end up using like a little bit of the space right here. And then we would have the spot where you can come and pick out your picnic baskets, AKA the backpacks that are gonna be full of food right here. And then this is where you return all of the old picnic baskets so that I can come back and grab them and like refill. Or maybe we should have like the picnic basket return back here, actually. Actually, that's a good idea. Because if we put the picnic basket return back here, then I'll be able to just come over. Well, but it's kind of rude to have the cashier station just right there. And then to decorate the interior, I think once we put some lighting and a DaVincing thing over here, it'll look a lot better. And what kind of lighting? I kind of feel like a classic little lantern would be sort of cute because we do have a lot of choices. Actually, for the torches, believe it or not, if we chisel the torches, you get quite a few different options. And I kind of feel like this little classic torch would be kind of cute right over here, maybe? I mean, I could be wrong, but for now, it's better than nothing, and it kind of fits a little bit, maybe? So we'll just leave that right there for now. I do think it actually kind of fits, and normally I don't like using that one for some reason. So yeah, sign, and then we're going to have this pickup spot, and then the payment spot. Maybe at the back. That would make sense. be like, please leave payments here. Yeah, you can reach it from back there. And then we'll have a little NPC right here. And then we might have some decorative, like, photo frames or, like, decorative pictures of, like, bears and picnic baskets. And we'll have a little cute decorative, like, picnic basket right here. And then you can reach past the NPC and there. All right, it's done. It's done. It was chaotic. It took a long time for such a simple little thing, but I'm really happy with it. And then we'll be building some really adorable little like picnic tables. I'm thinking we'll probably make the tables ourselves. Huh. I'm going to think about that. We might defense them, or we might end up using the Bibliocraft, because I want to be able to sit at them maybe, but you know what? Maybe instead of putting any kind of sitting things, we'll just go grab some of the log seats. Like, we could put some of these down. They're both lights and they're log seats. We'll grab some of these, which we can actually get. Believe it or not, Keeper Adlai is pulling up those stumps all the time. So we can come over to Keeper Adlai and Keeper Adlai, pardon me. Oh, there we go, Keeper Adlai. And we can help her out. And if we get enough zookeeper experience, we can put down the shiny logs. And then I'll also go ahead and I'll get some more of these ordered from Ben. And then we'll be able to install them next to the picnic place. And then we'll just put down a whole bunch of picnic blankets. And then Bob's your uncle. And it's a very easy thing to do. So wonderful. And then we'll just have to focus on kind of sprucing it up. And then visiting Junior and JJ to collect all of the leather. Because not only do I need to make tons and tons of picnic backpacks, but I also need to make tons and tons of mystery seed backpacks, because that's what I want to give to everybody as a gift. This should be a lot of fun. And I wonder if we should take this out actually and put like the tiny post right there as well. Actually, that might be really cute. Okay, I think we're gonna put tiny post like this right here as well. All right, I'll work on that and I will see you guys tomorrow, when hopefully we will be having, if nothing goes awry, the big Saturday special, where we'll work a little bit more on this, but then we'll also go around and we will try to gather up lots and lots and lots of leather. Oh, the girls are getting really hungry. Lots and lots and lots of leather, because we have a huge party to go to, basically like a huge gift giving parade to go to for you guys to be able to meet some of the new people, or at least see their bases. And this is going to be just fantastic. So, and that's enough for now, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye, guys!